I'm Geoffrey Rush. Hello, Tinseltown.
Geoffrey, in this long journey, what is the most important thing you've learned being in Hollywood?
Oh my God. It's a big question.
Of course.
Look, I've only been in and out of this town, I suppose, over a journey of about 7 years. Because of the intensity of this sort of event, you have to constantly keep reminding yourself that this is just the promotional side, the marketing side, that hopefully, because there are hundreds of other films out there, is going to give this film some public awareness. But that really the work you do is when you've got big eye bags at 6 a.m. and you're sitting in the makeup chair and you're looking at the day's script and you're sparking a few jokes with the other actors as they're being made up, and that you're going to do, hopefully, an honest day's work.
So how do you receive your creative inspiration?
It's a strange mixture, I suppose, of being potentially as loopy as you can be and being very relaxed, and to try and think laterally and play. Treat it like playing, like kids playing in a sandpit or playing in a playground, where you make the spontaneity of it as effortless as you can, even though sometimes that seems very daunting.
Would you do spiritually in your life to develop yourself? Yoga, prayers, meditations?
I don't do any of that stuff officially. I spend a fair amount of time quietly inside my own head, and I walk a lot. I suppose I remember once doing a sort of series of classes or workshops or whatever with a guy who talked to me about walking meditation, where you walk and you're active and alive, but you try and let nothing happen but what you're observing and moving on and seeing in passing, so that you don't get bombarded.
No, it's a very powerful way to connect to life, living things, nature, the elves in the garden, and the spirit beings in the forests and trees. So I have to ask you this. What does God mean to you, personally? Not organized religion, to you.
Isn't that funny? I've got young kids at the moment who are 8 and 10. And I'm sure for them, as for a lot of adults, they try and picture up a white-haired old guy that lives somewhere up there, like it's a medieval construct. But ultimately, it's something deep inside you that you know has an otherness to it that you know is there, and it's like frightening and awe-inspiring in its capabilities and size, and you only get tiny glimpses of it occasionally, where you go, isn't the natural phenomenal world so extraordinary? And then you lose sight of that, and it just seems like it's traffic and boring, you know.